Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll be explaining you helical antenna with great clarity. Before I start with explanation, let me show you how many things that I'm going to cover in this video. See, first of all, I'll be discussing about basics of helical antenna. After that, I'll explain you structure of helical antenna. After that, I'll explain you different types of ground planes with helical antenna. After that, I'll explain you two different modes of helical antenna. And at last, I'll be discussing about applications of helical antenna. So let us start this video with first agenda, that is basics of helical antenna. Helical antenna can be structured using single wire, where shape of wire that is wounded in a form of helix. You can observe here, see, we have single wire that is wounded in a form of helix over here. So that is helical antenna. Here also you can observe we have single wire that is wounded in a form of helix. Here you can observe we have helical antenna array in which we have four helical antennas in array form, where single wire that is wounded in a form of helix over here you can observe, right? So helical antenna that is having a single wire that is wounded in a form of helix, right? See, helical antenna that is having two spatial characteristics. First one is it is having broadband characteristics, means its bandwidth is higher compared to some other antennas like circular antenna, right? And here it can provide circular polarization. So because of it is having higher broadband characteristics and circular polarization, there are many applications which is there with helical antenna, right? And you will be observing it is having better directional characteristics compared to loop antenna. See, loop antenna can be having broadside radiation pattern or end fire radiation pattern, right? But helical antenna is having directional radiation characteristics. In this video, I'll show you how it is having directional radiation characteristics, right? But it is having way better directional radiation characteristics compared to circular antenna, right? Now, I'll explain you structure of helical antenna. Helical antenna can be structured simply using a single wire, where shape of wire that is wounded in a shape of helix. You can observe here we have a single wire that is wounded in a shape of helix, right? It is wounded in a shape of helix. Here, see, we have ground plane. This is ground plane. Let me note it down. And as and when you give signal to this helical antenna, at that time, see, with coaxial cable, inner conductor, that we will be connecting it with center wire, which is this helical wire, and outer conductor that we will be connecting it with this ground plane. So here I am showing you, see, inner conductor that we will be connecting it with phase over here, and that phase is connected with this helix, right? Now here you need to understand how shape of helix is there, right? So here we have number of turns with this helical antenna, where spacing between two turn, that is S over here. And if you see this helical antenna from the top view, then it will be appearing circle, where diameter of this circle, that is D. And based on diameter of this circle D, you can have circumference of wire, that is pi D. So what will be length of single circle in this helix? See, length of single circle of this helix, that will be based on this triangle, where with this triangle, spacing between two turn, that is S, circumference of circle, that is pi into D. So here L naught, that can be calculated based on Pythagoras theorem. L naught is square root of S square plus C square. And this alpha explains you how much spacing is there in between two consecutive turns. That tan alpha is S divided by C as per this triangle, right? See, this value of alpha explains you what kind of antenna is given to us. As if I say alpha is 0. If alpha is 0, what it means? Spacing between two turns, that is 0. As if spacing between two turns is 0, in that case, you will be having multiple loops overlaid on each other. Means, as if alpha is 0, then you will be having classic example of loop antenna only. Right. So, as if alpha is 0, we have loop antenna over here. Right. Now, in second scenario, what if we consider alpha is equals to 90 degree? If you have alpha is equals to 90 degree, in that case, we'll be having a straight wire over here. If you have straight wire, then that is a classic example of monopole antenna. So, to have a formation of helix over here, this value of alpha, that has to be there in between 0 to 90, right? So, that is how basic structure is there with helical antenna. Spacing between two turns, that is S. D is diameter of that turn. Here, see, this alpha explains you how spacing is there. And based on value of alpha, you can identify length of single turn. That is square root of S square plus C square. Right. Where this C is pi into D, that is circumference of circle. Now, I'll explain you different types of ground plane can be used with helical antenna. With helical antenna, in general, we use three different types of ground plane. See, if you observe here, we have plane ground plane. Second one is curved ground plane. And third one is deep conical ground plane. See, in plane ground plane, there is one condition that you need to understand. See, this diameter D, that has to be greater than 3 lambda by 4. Here, you need to understand this condition. See, this diameter D, that should be greater than 3 lambda by 4. That is the basic condition for proper operation over here. See, if you don't have D greater than 3 lambda by 4, then there will be increase in minor lobes over here. Right. Let me explain you how. See, if you observe radiation characteristics over here, then radiation characteristics will be having major lobe like this in axial mode. And there will be other lobes as well. Those are minor lobes, right? But if you have D, which is not greater than 3 lambda by 4, in that case, these minor lobes, that will increase, right? So here, what can be done to avoid minor lobes? But obviously, you can have infinite ground plane, but that is not practical idea. Right. If you have infinite ground plane, then you will be having minimum minor lobes over here. But that is not possible. Right. So here, there are a few basic points that you need to note down. If you want to suppress this minor lobe, then second idea is to have infinite ground plane. But this infinite ground plane, that is not possible over here. Right. That one should know. Now, if you observe second scenario and third scenario, then here you see in second scenario, we have curved ground plane. And in third scenario, we have deep conical ground plane. If you have curved ground plane or if you have deep conical ground plane, in that case, you will be having bit better radiation characteristics compared to plane ground plane. Let me show you how. See, here we'll be having major lobe, right? But minor lobes that will be having smaller size compared to plane ground plane, right? Here also we'll be having major lobe like this and minor lobe that is even further smaller compared to this in deep conical ground plane, right? So in curved ground plane, you will be observing we have less number of minor lobes, or you can say we have lower magnitude of minor lobes with these two category compared to plane ground plane. Secondly, because of this curve or because of this deep conical shape, we have protection of this helical antenna and it also provides better mechanical stability, right? That is how different types of ground planes that can be associated with helical antenna, right? Now I'll explain you different modes of operation with helical antenna. There are two types of operating modes with helical antenna. One is normal mode helix and second is axial mode helix. First of all, you need to understand how axis of helix is there. See here in diagram, let me show it to you. See, this is what axis of helix, right, which is passing through the center of circle, right? So this is what axis of helix. Now first of all, I'll be explaining you how radiation happens with normal mode of helix. See, normal mode of helix means there will be radiation which is perpendicular to axis of helix. So see, with normal mode, major lobes, those are happening like this, right? Major lobes, those are happening like this, and you will be observing minor lobes are happening in this direction like this. So here we have major lobes, and you will be observing, see, nearer to axis of helix there will be minor lobes. And in second mode we have axial mode of helix, right? See, in axial mode of helix, if you talk about radiation mechanism, then the radiation mechanism that is happening with major lobe towards axis of helix. So this is axis of helix. In this direction we'll be having major lobe, and minor lobe that is happening somewhat like this, right? So now you got the idea about how we have major lobe and minor lobe with axial mode and normal mode. Now let us talk about dimensions. See, if you talk about dimensions, then one should know with normal mode, dimensions are lower than lambda. While if you talk about axial mode, then here circumference, value of circumference, that should be in between 4/3 lambda to 3/4 lambda, right? Circumference that should be in between 4/3 lambda to 3/4 lambda for axial mode of operation, while dimensions should be lower than lambda in case of normal mode, right? That is how two different operating modes are there with helical antenna. Now let us talk about applications. See, there are many applications. Here I have listed few applications only. Like, we can have applications based on AM broadcast. We can use it to null down AC line noise. We can also use helical antennas to decrease TV sweep harmonics. And we have many low frequency applications as well, like in RFID, in gate parking, in airport, in door control, helical antennas can be used. So there are many applications which is there with helical antenna. I hope you have understood this. Still, if anything that you like to share, just note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.